Hare Krishna. Resenting reversals locks us in ignorance. Accepting reversals opens the door to transcendence. We all face reversals in life. That means, just like when a car is driving in reverse, it starts going in the direction opposite to which it is normally meant to go. Instead of going ahead, it starts going back. So reversals similarly push us in the reverse direction in life. Whatever plans we had, whatever direction we wanted to go, situations in life seem to be pushing us in the opposite direction. Our plans seem to be not only disrupted, but inverted. Not only can we not do what we want to do, but what we had planned to do, but we seem compelled to do the opposite of what we wanted to do. And such reversals can naturally cause resentment. Why is this happening to me? Why are my plans getting disrupted like this? However, resentment serves no constructive purpose. It simply locks us in ignorance. How in ignorance? Because when we have a particular plan and our plan is not working, then we need to broaden our vision to see what will work, what is working. And ultimately, God's plan is working, irrespective of whether our plan is working or not. And ignorance means to reduce our old vision to just our plan and to not see anything beyond that. Krishna says in the Bhagavad-Gita in 1822, Yattu krutsnavade kasmin karye saktamahaitukam atatvarthavadalpamcha tattamasamudharitam. He says that when we consider one thing to be everything without considering the whole picture, without understanding reality, that is a perception in the mode of ignorance. So when we consider the frustration of our plans to be the frustration of our life, and that's how we become resentful, then because our vision is getting locked into just that frustration, we are staying in ignorance, not seeing the big picture, not considering the possibility of a bigger plan. And that is unfortunate. What do we do otherwise? The alternative would be that we accept. Accept reversals means, okay, this has happened. My plan is not working, but Krishna is still my well-wisher. And Krishna always has a plan. Maya adhyakshena prakriti. Everything ultimately works under His supervision. So therefore, what this means is, let me try to see what Krishna's plan might be. Now, Krishna may enable us to move forward materially even through that situation, or Krishna may raise us spiritually through that situation. Either way, Krishna can help us. So transcendence means raising our consciousness above our situation so that we can see the big picture. So when we accept the situation, okay, it's accepted, it's happened, I accept it. Let me see what I can do, what I can learn. Now, then, especially if we are connected with Krishna and we raise our vision toward Krishna, then we find that some door will have opened in our life. And that door will take us closer to Krishna and with Krishna through that problem. Thus, acceptance in a mood of service. Karishye vachanam tava. As Krishna was told by Arjuna at the end of the Gita, I will do your will. So that brings peace, and that restored Arjuna's transcendental consciousness, where Arjuna says that his doubts are dispelled. His nashto moha smriti labdha tvat prasadan maya achyuta stito smigata sandeha karishye vachanam tava. So his doubts are dispelled, his calmness is restored. That means his consciousness has risen to transcendence. He is accepting Krishna's will. Similarly, if we too accept life's reversals, we will open the door to transcendence. Thank you. Hare Krishna.